G'day everyone. Well, we've got some rather special equipment here which we're going to be doing an autopsy on. This is the guts out of a LG DLP television. And for those who don't know what DLP is, it's digital light projection. It's a form of reprojection televisions. There's the old CRT type, which are the most common. And then you got the newer ones, which is this DLP. They don't use three CRTs like the older ones. Instead, they have one single lens. And they use a xenon arc lamp, which is in here, to fire a beam through a color wheel, which is around here, through a series of lenses and mirrors, which is under these covers, past a DLP chip, which is under that heatsink, through this lens, which reflects it onto a mirror, which then bounces out onto the screen. And don't worry, guys, I did keep the Fresnel lens, which, this is it here. It's a fairly big, or it was a fairly big set. I didn't really bother videoing it, but for those who follow me on Google Plus, then you'll know where that came from. But we're gonna have a look at this unit first. This is the controls and signal input. You've got your standard television input, 75 ohms resistance. You got video, S-video, VGA, which you can actually use these as a computer monitor if you wanted. Very big computer monitor in that case. Not 100% sure what that is. It's related to printers or something, I think. And yeah, dozens and dozens of these inputs here. I know the name of it, but I can't really remember it at the moment. But it does have a DVI connection from the, that's the main DLP processing unit. So that's what processes images and videos and pictures and whatever, and puts it into the main DLP mainboard, which is in there. You can see the one of the processor chips in there, which we can have a look at all of that. I'm going to do a big scan over once I get the whole thing torn down. But first thing we'll do is get this whole thing separated and have a look at some of these boards. And there you have it. It didn't take too long to get it apart. But that's your video and everything, TV input. It's got those classic, a lot of old VCRs and things. You'll find these metal RFI cans, which you've got wire-wound inductors and things inside. It's got LG on it, as you can see in there, little inductors and things. Lots of little surface mount electrolytic caps, a little quartz oscillator. That's 6000 Sunny 16-04-11. There's a Micromass SDA 5550M processor of some sort, and another one which has got a label over it. That's a removable one. That's not. I'm guessing a lot of these will probably be for processing the signal and everything, because that'll be just standard line signal input. And this will be processing it to put into this board here, which it then goes into this one, and that then goes into the DLP main board. But I'll get the rest of this RFI can off, and we can have a look at that big processor in there, as you can see. And there we go, that's one's out of its RFI can. There's its heatsink. Processor's not got as much written on it as I was hoping. It's a LG Electronics LGD T1502M0421, and it's a little power LED or something there. A lot more surface mount electrolytics, but so yeah, that'll probably be the signal processing board before it puts it into the main DLP main board, which is all in there. Which that's going to be part two. I'm just going to make both videos separate on this, but it's, yeah, I'll do a proper scan over of this, and you can all have a look if you want on what the, chips and things has got written on. There is a, Texas Instruments one right there, that tiny little one. It's, 35C59TT TFP410PAP, so that's that one there. We've got another Micromass. There's a lot of Micromasses on this thing. It's another X-Linux, X-Lynx, Hynix. Those analog devices. Another MicroNAS. Yeah, I'll do a proper scan over of all these boards and you can all have a look at what the processors are. Apologies, those are all upside down then. It's a little bit dusty, but it should work. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for part 2.